Hello guys, welcome to this YouTube channel. This is Sonam. Today in this Power Automate video tutorial, I am going to show you how to send a Microsoft Teams notifications when a task is completed in the planner. So here it is the preview of our flow that we are going to create. So as per the flow, it will trigger when a task is completed in the Microsoft Planner. And then it will get the user profile, and based on the user profile it will send the notification in the Teams, and also it will show us which user finished that task or completed that task. So let's see how to create this flow in the Power Automate. So before that, I'm showing you this is the result, how the result will come, how the notification will come in the user's Teams. So this is my one of the test things. So let's see how to create this flow and how to implement this. So in the browser, I'm just searching for office.com to sign up my user ID, and here it is asking for to sign in. So let's add our user ID and the password. Once it is done, the page will come like this, and as per our requirement, we are going to create a flow based on the Microsoft Teams and the planner. So in the app launcher, you can get all the applications based on yours of licensing. So if you are not finding these applications here, you can find here also. If all apps, you can find all the applications. Okay, let's go to that Power Automate and click on the ellipses and open in new tab. It will open in a new tab. Similarly, let's open the Power Planner so that we will assign some user to task, and when they completed the task, it will notify us. Okay, so in the Power Automate, let's create. And for the Microsoft Teams, I'm using the my desktop app. If you want, you can use also browser, from the browser apps you can use. But okay, let's see how to create this Power Automate flow. So in the Power Automate section, let's go to create, and here we can find all the types of varieties of the flow that we can create: instant cloud flow, automated cloud flow, scheduled cloud flow. And you can find already published some such flows that can be created: automated and the cloud and the scheduled cloud flow. You can find this flow tutorial in our site also and in our channel also. Let's go to that Power Automated cloud flow. Here I'm going to give a flow name. So suppose I'm giving the flow name send notification when task is completed, and for the trigger, when send notification when task is completed. So the trigger is our when a task is completed. So here we can search or we can skip it here, and we will add in our flow studio. So if I insert a simple the task is completed, yeah, this one under the planner connector, you can find that trigger. Okay, select this one and click on create. And now the trigger is asking to fill the mandatory fields like group ID and the plan ID. For the group ID, here we can insert any our group ID, the planner ID and the plan ID. For this, let's go to that. Let's come to our planner. So here I just created a planner, and here in the planner, so my under the team, I created based on the team one, and this one is the planner. And if you want to create anything, a new plan, so click here, and here you can create a new plan. Click new, and here you can enter the plan title and existing group, and the privacy you can set. And once you click on create, the plan will be created. Okay, so let's come to our daily task. So here this one is my plan. For now, this one is my planner where I need to assign the task to the user. Okay, so here I'm giving my group ID. So group ID is team one, and based on the group, team one group, I just created that task planner. So here the plan ID is daily task, and click on the new step. Once the task is completed, it will be triggered. Then what it will do, it will get the user details, the which user is finished that task. For that only, I will insert another action, that is get user detail. That the Office 365 user, you can find that action. So where is that get user profile, this one. So it will get the user profile who based on the ID who completed that assigned task. So here I am giving the principal name ID. Okay, so here we will search user ID, not user ID, assignment assigned ID. So for that, okay, yeah, this one, assignment assigned ID, the ID of the user to whom the this task was assigned to. Okay, so click on that and this will create a apply to each loop. So inside the loop we will add another action to post the message, post a message in team or chat. Yeah, this one, as we are going to, and by default it is showing us the flowbot, post as flowbot, or you can change any option here. Similarly, post in, as we are going to post this into our channel or in our group, so channel and team. Here the team is team 1 and the channel ID general, and here I am going to give some additional information so that user, when the notification it came, the user can get the ideas which task and who the person who completed that task. Okay, for that only, okay, a task has been date on date. So here I'm going to give a date, completed date. So you can undelete task. Here are the details. So I'm giving the task title. Okay, so keep this title, as I'm going to take it from the dynamic content. So if I search title, yeah, this is this one, title. And similarly, sorry, assign to, or you can like write like that, completed by. So I'm going to display name, and here we are going to from the get user profile. Under the get user profile we can find the display name content and the date. So I'm giving a date. Okay, and okay, that's it. So now user can get the ideas, completed on this date and their task title, display name, and who completed this, and the due date was that. Okay, for now, and our flow is now ready. Let's click on save, and once it is saved, let's test it. Okay, there is no issues. Okay, click on manually and test it. So to see it work now, completed task. Okay, let's come to our planner. So here I'm going to set a task, suppose it a report on Power BI using employee Excel data. Okay, and let's set a date. Suppose I'm giving a due date is Monday, and assign it to user 2, our test user. I'm going to set it as the our test user. So click on add text. Let's go to our, here I open my test user ID in my another browser. So this one is my test user ID. So this is showing, let's complete this task. Okay, now it's completed. So let's return to our Power Automate page, and as we can see, the flow ran successfully. That means it send this user, send the notification in Microsoft Teams. If we open this one, then we can find the person, all the details, like user 2. So the user 2 is completed this task. Let's open our Teams, and we can see there is a notification in Teams. So here, yeah, this one, a task has been completed on 24. Okay, so click on see more to, yeah, this one. So it's showing all the details that we just inserted in our planner. This is how we can create an automated cloud flow that will be triggered when a task is completed. I hope guys you like this video. Please give a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free videos, tutorial on SharePoint, online Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Python, Machine Learning, TypeScript and many more technologies, and share it as much as you can. Thank you. Have a nice day.